वेलकम टू फ्री ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑफ फिजिक्स विद लैम्बर सर। सो लास्ट लेक्चर वी स्टडीड रिगार्डिंग द सम नेचुरल फिनोमेना ड्यू टू सनलाइट, एंड ड्यू टू सनलाइट देयर आर नंबर ऑफ नेचुरल फिनोमेना आर टेकिंग प्लेस इन द नेचर एंड सराउंडिंग अस, एंड आउट ऑफ दैट ओनली टू नेचुरल फिनोमेना वाज सेट फॉर अवर सिलेबस। First natural phenomena is the mirage, which is nothing but optical illusion. And we discussed in detail about the mirage. And the second natural phenomena was the formation of rainbow. Both the phenomena are arising due to sunlight. And this rainbow formation of rainbow, there are two types, primary rainbow and secondary rainbow. Now, in this lecture, we will discuss about the defects of lenses. What are the defects? What are their types of the defects of lenses, which are also called as aberrations of optical images? So, during the formation of images by lenses and mirrors, lens and mirrors यांच्याकडून इमेजचं फॉर्मेशन होत असतानाच at the same time deriving different relations such as lens maker's equation, lens formula, these are the relations for lenses, and mirror equation is the relation for mirror. There are certain assumptions, and if that assumptions are satisfied, then the images formed by lenses or mirrors will be clear without any defects in that. And if that assumptions are not satisfied, then images will be introduced certain defects. So which are the observations which are made for the formation of images by lenses and mirrors? The first assumption is that objects are very small in size. म्हणजे जे ऑब्जेक्ट्स आपण यूज करतोय त्या ऑब्जेक्ट्सची साईज व्हेरी स्मॉल असेल, म्हणजेच त्यांच्या इमेजेस देखील व्हेरी स्मॉल इन साईज मध्ये असतील. दिस इज द फर्स्ट अझम्पशन. नाउ द सेकंड अझम्पशन इज दॅट ऑब्जेक्ट्स आर प्लेस्ड very close to the principal axis of lens or mirror. म्हणजे principal axis आणि object या मधलं distance हे जास्त असू नये. That objects are placed very close to the principal axis of lens or mirror. And third assumption जे आहे, this third assumption explain that different rays of light coming from the object are parallel to the principal axis. The rays of light coming from the object should not be inclined with principal axis. That rays should be parallel to the principal axis. So these are the main three assumptions that should be satisfied. In actual practice, these assumptions are not satisfied. Therefore, certain defects are introduced in the images produced by mirrors and lenses. म्हणजे इथं जी काय थ्री अझम्पशन्स आहेत, इफ दॅट थ्री अझम्पशन्स आर नॉट सॅटिस्फाईड, देन सर्टन डिफेक्ट्स विल बी इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन द इमेजेस फॉर्म्ड बाय मिरर्स अँड लेन्सेस. दॅट इमेजेस विल बी नॉट क्लिअर, शार्प अँड वेल डिफाईन्ड. Certain defects will be there. Then, due to these defects, the images are distorted or defective, blurred and indistinct instead of being sharp and well defined. म्हणजे ह्या पद्धतीची assumption जर satisfy झाली नाही तर certain defects introduce होतील in the images formed by lenses and mirrors. And that defects mula, the images will be distorted or defective, blurred, indistinct, instead of being sharp and well defined. मग अशा प्रकारचे जे डिफेक्ट्स इमेजेस मध्ये इन्वॉल्व होतील त्या डिफेक्ट्स ना आपण काय म्हणणार पहा. सच डिफेक्ट्स आर कॉल्ड एज एबरेशन्स. सो वी विल स्टडी द टाइप्स ऑफ सच एबरेशन्स और टाइप्स ऑफ लेंस डिफेक्ट्स. टाइप्स ऑफ डिफेक्ट्स और एबरेशन्स. द एबरेशन्स आर मेनली ऑफ टू टाइप्स. इमेज फॉर्मेशन होत असताना जी एबरेशन्स इंट्रोड्यूस होणार आहेत दॅट आर क्लासिफाइड इन टू टू टाइप्स. फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ एबरेशन इज क्रोमॅटिक एबरेशन एंड द सेकंड टाइप ऑफ एबरेशन इज मोनोक्रोमॅटिक एबरेशन. नाउ लेट अस लर्न विच एबरेशन इज कॉल्ड एज अ क्रोमॅटिक एबरेशन. क्रोमॅटिक एबरेशन म्हणजे नेमकं काय? So, the aberration which is introduced due to the presence of rays of different wavelengths, that means rays of different colors in the incident light, is called chromatic aberration. म्हणजे जी light lens वर किंवा mirror वर incident होईल त्या incident light मध्ये डिफरंट कलरचे रेज जर प्रेझेंट असतील, डिफरंट वेवलेंथचे रेज जर प्रेझेंट असतील, तर जी एबिरेशन्स इमेज मध्ये इंट्रोड्यूस होती त्या एबिरेशन्सना क्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशन्स असं म्हणायचं. सो इन क्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशन द एबिरेशन्स आर ड्यू टू रेज ऑफ डिफरंट वेवलेंथ्स और डिफरंट कलर्स इन द इन्सिडेंट लाईट. नाउ वी विल लर्न the second type of aberration is the monochromatic aberration. In this aberration, aberrations which are introduced even when incident light is monochromatic. That is, incident light composed of rays of single wavelength or same color are called monochromatic aberrations. म्हणजे ज्या aberrations मध्ये इन्सिडेंट लाईट ही मोनोक्रोमॅटिक यूज करून पण काही एबिरेशन जर इंट्रोड्यूस होत असतील इमेजेस मध्ये तर त्या एबिरेशन्सना आपण मोनोक्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशन असं म्हणायचं. म्हणजे क्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशन हे इन्सिडेंट लाईट मध्ये डिफरंट वेवलेंथ रेज ऑफ डिफरंट वेवलेंथ किंवा रेज ऑफ डिफरंट कलर्स प्रेझेंट असल्यामुळे क्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशन. आणि मोनोक्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशन्स इन्सिडेंट रेज सेम वेवलेंथचे सेम कलरचे यूज करून देखील जी एबिरेशन्स इंट्रोड्यूस होतात इन द इमेजेस फॉर्म्ड बाय लेन्सेस अँड मिरर्स दॅट एबिरेशन्स आर कॉल्ड एज मोनोक्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशन्स. आता ह्या मोनोक्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशनचे 5 टाइप्स आहेत. सो टाइप्स ऑफ मोनोक्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशन्स. मोनोक्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशन्स आर ऑफ 5 टाइप्स. लेट अस सी वन बाय वन. 5 types. See here. First type, spherical aberration. Second type is the coma. Third is the astigmatism. Fourth one is the curvature of field. And fifth type of monochromatic aberration is distortion. So in all, there are 5 types of monochromatic aberrations which are introduced even when incident light is monochromatic. That is, light of single color. Use karun dekhil, ji aberrations introduce hotat, tyana apan monochromatic aberrations manna. Itha, ek point apan remember karayla pahije, lakshat thevayla pahije, to konta pa? Ya 5 types paiki, except spherical aberration, see here, except spherical aberration, all the remaining 4 aberrations arises due to beams or rays of light inclined to the principal axis. Actually, आपण assumption काय केलेले आहेत पहा, 3 assumptions केली, त्यातली तिसरा assumption, the rays of light coming from the object should be parallel to the principal axis. आता हे जे incident rays लेन्सवर किंवा मिररवर येणारे इन्सिडेंट रेज प्रिन्सिपल ऍक्सिसला पॅरलल नसतील, म्हणजे इन्क्लाइंड असतील, तर इन्सिडेंट रेच्या इन्क्लिनेशनमुळं जी एबिरेशन्स इन्व्हॉल्व होतात ती एबिरेशन्स मध्ये कोमा, अस्टिगमॅटिझम, कर्वेचर ऑफ फील्ड अँड डिस्टॉर्शन या चार एबिरेशन्सचा समावेश होतो. म्हणजे स्पेरिकल एबिरेशन्स, इन्क्लाइंड इन्सिडेंट रेज किंवा बीम्स यामुळं अराइज होत नाहीत. बाकीची चार एबिरेशन्स आर ड्यू टू beams or rays inclined to principal axis. So in this session we are discussing first type of aberration, which is the chromatic aberration. So we know that chromatic aberration arises due to rays of different wavelength, that is rays of different colors, which are present in the incident light. That's why this aberration is introduced due to the presence of rays of different wavelengths, that is the rays of different colors in the incident light. So let us explain chromatic aberration. And to explain this chromatic aberration, we will consider lens maker's equation for the focal length of lens, which we have derived in the previous session. So lens maker equation for focal length of the lens is 1 upon f equal to n minus 1 into bracket 1 upon r1 minus 1 upon r2. And this equation gives us focal length of both convex lens as well as concave lens. Ya equation madhe itha n2 upon n1 hota. मग त्यातील एन वन इज द रिफ्रॅक्टिव्ह इंडेक्स ऑफ सराउंडिंग मीडियम, आणि जर सराउंडिंग मीडियम एअर असेल तर एन वन इक्वल टू वन आपण घेतलं. मग त्यावेळी एन टू ही जी रिफ्रॅक्टिव्ह इंडेक्स आहे ती रिफ्रॅक्टिव्ह इंडेक्स त्या लेन्सच्या मटेरियल मीडियमची घेतली आणि ती इथं आपण एन दाखवलेली आहे. सो इन दिस इक्वेशन एफ गिव्ज यू फोकल लेंथ ऑफ द लेन्स, एन गिव्ज यू रिफ्रॅक्टिव्ह इंडेक्स ऑफ मटेरियल ऑफ लेन्स, R1 radius of curvature of first surface, R2 radius of curvature of second surface. आता इथं ही जी रिफ्रॅक्टिव्ह इंडेक्स आहे लेन्सच्या मटेरियलची, द रिफ्रॅक्टिव्ह इंडेक्स ऑफ द मटेरियल ऑफ लेन्स इज डिफरंट फॉर डिफरंट कलर्स, वी नो दॅट. आणि या रिफ्रॅक्टिव्ह इंडेक्सवर त्या लेन्सची फोकल लेंथ डिपेंड आहे, इनव्हर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल आहे. मग जर लेन्सच्या मटेरियलची रिफ्रॅक्टिव्ह इंडेक्स डिफरंट असेल फॉर डिफरंट कलर्स, तर त्या लेन्सची फोकल लेंथ विल बी ऑल्सो डिफरंट फॉर डिफरंट कलर्स. इज इट क्लिअर? ऍज द रिफ्रॅक्टिव्ह इंडेक्स ऑफ मटेरियल ऑफ लेन्स इज डिफरंट फॉर डिफरंट कलर्स, वी नो दॅट रिफ्रॅक्टिव्ह इंडेक्स of the material of lens is maximum for violet color and minimum for red color, and it has intermediate values for the remaining colors. And this refractive index and focal length of the lens are inversely proportional. So we can say that focal length of that lens is also different for different colors. Now we can write focal length for the extreme colors in the beam of white light. So focal length of the lens for violet and red colors, using this lens maker's equation, we can write like this. So this is the focal length for violet color, and we can write the focal length for red color using the lens maker equation. This is the focal length for red color. In this equation, NV and NR, what is that? NV and NR are the refractive index of the lens, material of lens cha refractive index for violet and red colors. Isn't it? And What will happen to the focal length for the remaining colors in between violet and red? So the focal length of other colors between violet and red, the focal length of other colors have their values intermediate between focal length for violet color and focal length for red color. And we know that refractive index of material of lens is greater for violet color than for red color. But refractive index and focal length are inversely proportional. So we can write here, as refractive index for violet color is greater than refractive index for red color, we can write here, the focal length of lens for violet color will be less than focal length for red color. That's the relation we are getting. Thus, we can say that the focal length of lens for violet color is less than that for red color. आता एखाद्या लेन्सवर आपण पॅरलल बीम ऑफ लाईट जर इन्सिडेंट केला, when parallel beam of polychromatic light, we can say, means white light, is passed through a lens, parallel beam of polychromatic light is passed through a lens, the beam is deviated as well as dispersed by the lens. We know the property of that lens. A parallel beam of polychromatic light while passing through lens may be convex lens or concave lens. That beam is deviated, means its direction changes, means undergoes refraction. At the same time, that beam is dispersed by the lens. That means that beam is splitted, separated into its constituent colors. And when such parallel beam of light is incident on convex lens and it is incident on concave lens, then it will suffer chromatic aberration. Why it will suffer chromatic aberration? We will discuss it with the help of ray diagram. See here. This is the ray diagram regarding the convex lens on which parallel beam of light is incident on convex lens. So this diagram explains chromatic aberration in convex lens. Now, one more ray diagram regarding the concave lens. This diagram is explaining chromatic aberration in concave lens. So when parallel beam of light, parallel beam of polychromatic light is incident on convex lens or concave lens, this polychromatic beam consists rays of 7 different colors with violet and red as extreme colors. What happens when such a beam means beam, polychromatic beam of light, parallel polychromatic beam of light passes through convex lens or concave lens. You can see convex lens, concave lens. What happens? We know that the material of lens has less focal length for violet color, and material of lens has greater focal length for red color. And the focal lengths of other colors are intermediate between FV and FR. म्हणजे FV पेक्षा जास्त आणि FR पेक्षा कमी focal lengths remaining 5 colors आहे. That's why while passing through the lens, parallel beam of polychromatic light, when it passes through convex lens, when it passes through concave lens, what happens? The rays of violet colors undergoes maximum deviation and come closer to lens at focus FV. You can say in this diagram, FV is the focus which is closer to this lens. At this focus, the rays of violet colors आर कॉन्वर्ज, व्हाइल द रेज ऑफ रेड कलर्स यू कैन सी, ज्यांना लेन्सची फोकल लेंथ लार्ज आहे, व्हाइल द रेज ऑफ रेड कलर्स सफर द लीस्ट डेविएशन and comes to focus FR further away. The same thing is happening in case of concave lens. When parallel beam of polychromatic light passes through concave lens, what happens? The rays of violet colors having the less focal length, isn't it? The rays of violet colors undergoes maximum deviation and comes closer to focus FV, nearer to the slits. While the rays of red colors, ki janchi refract, janchi focal length jaasti, the rays of red colors suffer the least deviation and come to focus FR further away, which is clearly explained in this ray diagram. And what happens to the rays of other colors? Remaining five colors cha rays kay hona? See here. The rays of other colors converge at points between FV and FR. So in this way, when parallel beam of polychromatic light passes through convex lens or concave lens, the rays of violet colors converge at focus FV close to the lens, and the rays of red colors converge at focus FR further away from the lens. This thing is happening. And if this refracted light from the lens, is allowed to fall on the screen, म्हणजे दोन्हीही लेन्स मधून जी लाईट रिफ्रॅक्ट झालेली आहे ती लाईट जर आपण स्क्रीनवर अलाउ केली, व्हॉट इज अवर ऑब्झर्वेशन? इट विल बी ऑब्झर्व दॅट ऍट पॉइंट एफ व्ही अँड ऍट पॉइंट एफ आर, व्हॉट विल बी अवर ऑब्झर्वेशन? सो ऍट फोकस एफ व्ही, ज्या फोकस जवळ व्हायलेट कलरचे रेज कॉन्वर्ट झालेले आहेत, ऍट फोकस एफ व्ही इमेज इज अ व्हायलेट स्पॉट surrounded by colored rings with the red ring in the outermost position. म्हणजे FV focus जवळ आपल्याला violet spot मिळेल, त्यानंतर तुम्हाला ज्या colored rings मिळणार आहेत त्या Bjorkच्या sequence ने मिळणार. म्हणजे FV point जवळ violet spot, नंतर indigo ची colored ring, blue color ring, green color ring, right, that outermost color ring will be red. And at the focus FR, what will we see? At the focus FR, the image is a red spot surrounded by colored rings with the violet ring in the outermost position. This is our observation. If we collect the refracted light on the screen, and that screen is placed perpendicular to principal axis. Screen upon principal axis la perpendicular place karnar hai. And that screen will be placed anywhere between the points FV and FR. Perpendicular to principal axis to upon screen thevaycha. And to screen anywhere will be between point FV and FR. Then on the screen, what we will observe? At point FV, FVR focus zavar, we will see violet spot surrounded by colored rings with violet ring in the outermost position. While at focus FR, the image will be, the image is a red spot surrounded by colored rings with violet ring in the outermost position. And FV is our violet spot male surrounded by the colored rings with outermost red ring So in this way, we will get the image of that point object. Thus, it is found that instead of producing point image for point object, म्हणजे कॉन्वेक्स लेन्स किंवा कॉन्केव लेन्स कडून जी इमेज फॉर्म झालेली आहे ती ऍक्च्युअली आपल्याला पॉइंट इमेज होती हवी होती पॉइंट ऑब्जेक्ट ची बट द इमेज फॉर्म्ड बाय लेन्स इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ सर्क्युलर रिंग्स विच इज कलर्ड इनडिस्टिंक्ट अँड स्प्रेड अलॉन्ग अ लाईन between the focus FB and FR. So, on the screen, it is found that instead of producing point image for point object, the lens produces circular image. The circle spread between point FB and FR. The lens produces circular image. That image is colored, indistinct. And that circular image is sprayed along a line between the focus FV and FR. आणि या प्रकारची इमेज या प्रकारचा डिफेक्ट जर इमेज मध्ये येत असेल तर त्या डिफेक्टला आपण क्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशन असं म्हणतो. सो दिस इफेक्ट डिफेक्ट विच इज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन द इमेज इज कॉल्ड एज क्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशन. सी हियर, दिस डिफेक्ट इज कॉल्ड chromatic aberration. So, in the presence of chromatic aberration, in case of both convex and concave lenses, the image formed by lenses will be circular, colored, indistinct, and sprayed along the line between the focus FB and FR. That is our final conclusion. So, due to presence of chromatic aberrations, instead of getting point image of point object, we get circular image which is colored, indistinct, and spread along the line between the points FV and FR. Now, we will learn the methods to reduce the chromatic aberrations, to eliminate the chromatic aberration. That methods we will learn here. So, methods reducing or eliminating chromatic aberrations. Eliminating chromatic aberrations for all colors is impossible because in polychromatic light, that means white light, there are 7 different colors. And here 7 different colors ni ji chromatic aberration introduce kela asel. त्या 7 डिफरंट कलर्स क्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशन्स इलिमिनेट करणं इम्पॉसिबल आहे. सो क्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशन्स फॉर ऑल कलर्स कॅनॉट बी कम्प्लिटली इलिमिनेटेड. हेन्स क्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशन्स कॅन बी मिनिमाइज्ड बाय इलिमिनेटिंग एबिरेशन्स फॉर एक्स्ट्रीम कलर्स, दॅट मीन्स फॉर व्हायलेट अँड रेड कलर्स. व्हायलेट आणि रेड कलरचं क्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशन्स आपण कम्प्लिटली इलिमिनेट करून क्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशन आपण मिनिमाइज करू शकतो. अँड टू इलिमिनेट क्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशन्स फ्रॉम द एक्स्ट्रीम कलर्स व्हायलेट अँड रेड कलरचं क्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशन्स फॉर लेन्स आपल्याला कम्प्लिटली इलिमिनेट करायचं असेल तर ते इलिमिनेशन आपण अचीव करू शकतो बाय युजिंग टू लेन्सेस. सो दिस इलिमिनेटिंग क्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशन्स फ्रॉम फॉर एक्स्ट्रीम कलर्स फ्रॉम द लेन्स इज अचीव्ड बाय दिस इज अचीव्ड बाय युजिंग कॉन्व्हेक्स अँड कॉन्केव लेन्स इन कॉन्टॅक्ट. म्हणजे या दोन लेन्सचं कॉम्बिनेशन यूज करून कॉन्व्हेक्स आणि कॉन्केव लेन्सचं कॉम्बिनेशन यूज करून we can eliminate chromatic aberrations for the extreme colors from the lens. म्हणजे extreme color ने introduce केलेलं chromatic aberration आपण completely eliminate करू शकतो by using the combination of convex lens and concave lens. And such combination, which eliminates chromatic aberrations for extreme colors, is called a chromatic lens. म्हणजे कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ कॉन्वेक्स अँड कॉन्केव्ह लेन्स विच इलिमिनेट्स क्रोमॅटिक एबिरेशन फॉर एक्स्ट्रीम कलर्स इज कॉल्ड अ क्रोमॅटिक लेन्स अँड दॅट अ क्रोमॅटिक लेन्स वी कॅन सी लाईक दिस सो यू कॅन सी हियर दिस इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ कॉन्वेक्स लेन्स अँड कॉन्केव्ह लेन्स विच आर केप्ट इन कॉन्टॅक्ट And such combination of lens is called as achromatic lens. And this achromatic lens is used to eliminate chromatic aberrations for the extreme colors from the lens. Okay, now we will learn few mathematical terms related to chromatic aberrations. See here, which are that? Longitudinal chromatic aberration, transverse chromatic aberration, and the circle of least confusion that we will learn here. And to learn this concept, we will go through one ray diagram which is explaining chromatic aberration for convex lens. See here, this ray diagram is explaining chromatic aberration for the convex lens. This one is a convex lens and beam of polychromatic light, that is white light, is incident on this convex lens. When these rays, parallel rays, which are incident on convex lens, passes through the lens, we know that the rays of violet colors undergoes maximum deviation and comes to focus FV nearer the lens. You can see FV is the focus for the violet colors. And the rays of red colors undergoes least deviation and comes to focus FR further away from the lens. Due to this, instead of forming point image or point object, the lens produces circular image which is colored, indistinct, and that circular image is spread along a line between the focus FV and FR. And regarding this chromatic aberration, we can explain longitudinal chromatic aberration. In short, it is called as LCA. Longitudinal chromatic aberration. We can explain circle of least confusion and we can explain transverse chromatic aberration. So, what is longitudinal chromatic aberration? First of all, we will explain. So, it is the distance between focus of violet color and focus of red color. Because the rays of violet colors undergoes maximum deviation and converge at focus FV closer to the lens, and the rays of red color undergoes least deviation and converge at focus FR further away from the lens. The distance between focus of violet color and focus of red color gives us longitudinal chromatic aberration. So, longitudinal chromatic aberration is the distance between focus point of violet color and focus point of red color, which is explained here. And in this diagram, we see that red, green, and blue color rays. See here. Red, blue, and green color che rays hai. And this one is the optical axis, which is nothing but principal axis of this lens. After that, the green color sati best focus point of the ha diagram madhe disto. Then second is the circle of least confusion. What is that circle of least confusion? We know that the image formed by this lens due to chromatic aberration, इज अ सर्क्युलर पॅच, इज अ सर्क्युलर इमेज विच इज कलर्ड इनडिस्टिंक्ट अँड स्प्रेड अलॉंग अ लाईन. दॅट्स वाय दॅट सर्क्युलर इमेज हॅज डिफरंट डायमीटर अलॉंग दॅट लाईन. And this image is observed by using screen in between the points FV and FR. So in presence of chromatic aberration, instead of producing point image or point object, the lens produces circular, indistinct and colored image which is spread along the line. The circular patch tumhala image cha milto instead of point image. And this image can be collected on a screen between FV and FR. Then at a certain position or particular location of the screen between FV and FR, the diameter of this circular image is minimum. You can see here, this is the circular image whose diameter is minimum. And this circle of minimum diameter, this circular image of minimum diameter is called as circle of least confusion. So circle of least confusion is the circular image of minimum diameter which can be seen on the screen. Now the third term related to chromatic aberration is that transverse chromatic aberration. Transverse chromatic aberration. What is that? This is the radius of circle of least confusion. You can see here. This one, this distance. This distance is the radius of the circle of least confusion. Gives us transverse chromatic aberration. So the transverse chromatic aberration is the radius of circle of least confusion. Is called transverse chromatic aberration. So with this, I hope that you understand the concepts regarding the defects of lenses, the aberrations of images, optical images. And we come to know that there are main two types of aberrations, chromatic aberrations and monochromatic aberrations. And in this lecture, we have explained chromatic aberrations. And we come to know that this chromatic aberration cannot be completely eliminated for the all rays, for the colors of all rays. So chromatic aberrations cannot be completely eliminated for the rays of all colors, but we can eliminate chromatic aberrations for the extreme colors by using combination of two lenses, convex and concave. Such combination of concave and convex lens, which is used to eliminate chromatic aberrations for extreme colors, is called as achromatic lens. And in the next lesson, we will study achromatic lens and its use. With this, we are ending this lecture.